In this lecture, we'll find the time period of oscillation of pendulum inside a vehicle which is freely falling along the inclined plane. Now, along the inclined plane, we know if this is the inclined plane and this is theta, the gravity, which is g downwards, can be resolved in two components. One is g cos theta and another is g sine theta. So this bob, the ball or the pendulum, in reference to this frame which I am taking, now I am working the problem in reference to the inclined plane, will experience g cos theta is perpendicular and g sine theta is horizontal. So if we look at the pendulum now, this pendulum with some small displacement alpha has, one is g cos theta is the acceleration, is force, acceleration force here, mg cos theta, and this force will be mg sine theta. So this from the in the first sight seems to be different from the normal case of pendulum. So, or I can rotate it and see it that way also. Normal case of pendulum, you had only one force which is acting, which is this is alpha, so this is mg is the downward force. Only one force was acting on the pendulum. There is no horizontal force on this bob. Only the vertical forces were acting in reference to this frame. Here, in reference to this frame, because oscillation I am seeing perpendicular to this inclined plane, there are two forces. One is not only the vertical force, but also the horizontal force. So can we straight away use this formula, T is 2 pi root L upon G. Instead of g, you will write g cos theta. But is it correct to use it? Because in normal case of pendulum, there was no horizontal force. No net horizontal force on this bob. But here, at the first sight, it appears you have to take this force also into account. But this force is getting cancelled because of the pseudo force. The whole body is also moving with acceleration g sine theta. So there is a pseudo force of g sine theta, mg sine theta, in the opposite direction. These two forces, the force due to the inclined plane, the gravity along the inclined plane, gets cancelled because of the free fall of the body, so, and the pseudo force. So these two gets cancelled. So here also you have a simple case of pendulum where instead of g, you have g cos theta. Everything remains the same. The derivation I'm not doing for the pendulum, you know, time period for pendulum was t 2 pi root L upon g. So instead of g, you write g cos theta, provided it's a free fall. The fall has to be smooth, there is no friction, then straight away you can use this formula.